members of the Boston School Board. Starting January 1st, the mayor, Mayor Flynn, will appoint school committee members. The governor thinks this will go a long way toward improving the school system in Boston. They figured out what caused the Seabrook nuke plant to shut down a couple of days ago. Technicians working on the problem say there was dirt in the electrical connectors that caused a short circuit of one of the four reactor coolant pumps. Saddam Hussein now says UN inspectors are free to check out Iraqi nuclear sites, but the acting U.S. ambassador to the United Nations is taking a wait-and-see attitude. Alexander Watkins says what matters is not what Saddam says, but what he does. Soviet leader Mikhail Gorbachev says those who want to dissolve the Soviet Union should note the bloodshed in Yugoslavia. Gorbachev says there'd be a great risk and unpredictable consequences for the USSR if it were to break apart. The National Organization for Women, NOW, says it will fight the confirmation of Clarence Thomas to the Supreme Court. And delegates to the National Education Association Convention in Miami Beach have approved a resolution expressing grave concerns about Thomas's conservative view. Those are some of the stories we're following at this hour here at WBZ, Boston's news station. It's 25 before 3. We'll have a complete check on the news at 3 o'clock. And, of course, we keep in touch with all the stuff going on throughout the world, around the clock on WBZ. And that includes traffic as well. WBZ 24-Hour Traffic Network, Jack Hart, has all kinds of information for you on that. How are we doing there? This is the inebriate time again, huh?
Yes, indeed. We are awash with inebriates right now.
They're just taking over the world, those inebriates. You give them the right to vote, and next thing you know, they're taking over the entire government, every road. And
yes,
they
indeed.
Drunkenness. Drunkenness is our philosophy. Vote for our drunken party.
Absolutely.
Are there really that many drunks on the road?
Well, according to our police scanners, absolutely, there's plenty out and about. And, of course, this is the holiday weekend, and we do see an overabundance of them on a weekend such as this. In fact, we have a minor problem as a result on Route 1A in Lynn, the Lynnway. A hit-and-run accident, some minor injury, minor, thankfully. So do watch out for that. Should be cleared up before too long. However, that did spill some fuel from that vehicle on the roadway. We do have some sanders heading out there to try and keep it from being too slippery, but there will be some debris as well in that roadway once that's cleared away. In the downtown area, a disabled vehicle on the expressway heading northbound by Columbia is something to watch out for. Southbound on the expressway down around Neponset, Metro Police dealing with a carload of inebriates just about to haul them off to where they should be going. And anyway, otherwise on Route 128, 495, we're in pretty good shape, and after 6 a.m., expect delays on Route 128 in Burlington and on many of the side roads as people flock to Henscombe Air Force Base for the day's events there. I'm Jack Hart, WBZ, 24-Hour Traffic Network. Go to Bat for the Jimmy Fund. Play the triple winner game at Stop and Shop. All donations go to support the Jimmy Fund, and every ticket's a winner. It's time to Stop and Shop.
Remodeling a kitchen is usually an expensive project that can disrupt your home for weeks. But Sears Kitchen Cabinet Refacing is the affordable way to give your kitchen a dramatic new look without major construction. Installation can often be completed in just 72 hours or less. Call now for a free in-home estimate and you can save 15%. Sears authorized craftsmen use your existing cabinet framework, covering exposed surfaces and replacing doors, drawer fronts, and hardware, all in your choice of style and color. When you call, a Sears authorized consultant will visit your home and show you how easy it is to transform your kitchen. There's no obligation, and it's backed by Sears, a name you can trust. So don't replace, just reface your cabinets quickly and affordably. Be sure to call 1-800-942-3600 now and save 15%. Offer expires July 15th. Call 1-800-942-3600. That's 1-800-942-3600.
Okay, we'll take some more calls, you betcha. Eric in Norwood. Hi, Eric.
Hello.
Oh, hello, Eric. How you doing?
I would like to say that Macho King Randy Savage, I think that he was real because I've heard him on Primetime Wrestling and everything else. And Macho King, how are you supposed to get the WWF title back if you cannot, because the big and awesome Ultimate Warrior beat you at the 1990 Royal Rumble to kick you out of wrestling permanently in the WWF.
Wow, I wish you'd been on the phone when we talked to him. And I didn't know that was what you wanted to talk about. We could have hooked you both up and you could have asked him that directly. Maybe we'll have to check with him next time. I hope he'll call again. But that really happened, huh?
Yeah, him and the Ultimate Warrior, they signed for a match at last year's Royal Rumble, and whoever lost would be the end of their career. And the Ultimate Warrior totally won, and he kicked his butt.
And he kicked his butt.
the second guy, the guy that talked after him,
although the fellow who was skeptical about it all.
Yeah.
Yeah, he didn't figure. He thought maybe that was kind of a phony. But you're.
I think if it is possible, I really doubt it. But I doubt it. It could be possible because it is pretty easy to fake his voice. He said something about stepping in the ring with Hulk Hogan. Him and Hulk Hogan, the first match I ever saw, were a tag team. And they went against somebody else. And Miss Elizabeth, the guy Macho Man is marrying, was their manager. And I think that he is really true because he said he was getting married with Miss Elizabeth because last week on primetime, on Monday night, they had Miss Elizabeth say her emotions, what she felt about Macho King, and she said that she loved him. And let's see, today's Saturday. Today's Saturday. On Monday, Macho King is supposed to say, so I believe at SummerSlam, they will probably get married.
Oh, is she a pretty lady?
When she managed Hulk Hogan and Macho Man, she was shocking. Was a babe. And I saw her now. She's not as good as she was.
When you say she was shocking, what do you mean by that?
She was wearing a blue dress with high heel pumps, and she had pantyhose on, and she had her hair back. She had nice earrings, and she was beautiful. And she got knocked out during the match, and that's when Macho King and Hulk Hogan split up because she got knocked out. Hulk Hogan took her back into the locker room. Hulk Hogan left Randy Savage in the ring by himself, and he came back out. Macho King tagged Hulk Hogan. They won the match, but as soon as Hulk Hogan got back in the locker room, Macho King was waiting for him, and Macho King just beat the crap out of him. And that's when they split up. Hulk Hogan was crying. He was going around in the back and back, and he was asking, and he was looking for him, and he was just all broken up. Now I can't wait. I'm wondering what the result. They were supposed to have a match June 29th, the Hulk Hogan against The Undertaker. Right now, Hulk Hogan does have the belt, but I don't know who won that match. So the Ultimate Warrior beat The Undertaker, and the Ultimate Warrior, I think that one of my friends said the Hulk Hogan was planning on retiring when he got the belt. He has not retired yet. And if he does retire to the belt, I think the number one contender that should get that belt is the Ultimate Warrior. Because the only reason why he lost it to Sergeant Slaughter is because that butt wipe, Macho King, he came out and he hit Ultimate Warrior over the head. They had these big lights. He hit him over the head with that. And Macho King has this wand like he's a king. And it was glass, and he hit that over the Ultimate Warrior's head. And that was They didn't even disqualify him. So that was an unfair match. Anybody in the Wrestling Federation could beat Sergeant Slaughter's butt. He sucks.
Okay, so, Eric, you're starting to get violent now, Eric. No, I appreciate your comments, Eric, and I've got to move along, but I thank you very much for your incisive analysis of all the stuff going on.
I hope somebody can call and tell me who won those matches on June 29th, please. Thank you.
Okay, Eric. Bye-bye now. Oh, my goodness.
Meet the Flaxes, not exactly your ordinary family. Sexy, sassy, and single Mrs. Flax has a kinship with her two daughters that ranges from rivalry to revelry to hilarity in this comedy of romantic wanderlust. This wacky trio careen through romantic escapades and unusual encounters with plenty of witty dialogue. Mermaids, set to classic tunes of the rock and roll 60s, stars Academy Award winner Cher, Bob Hoskins, Winona Ryder, and Christina Ricci. On video cassette from Orion Home Video, rated PG. Rent Mermaids at any Blockbuster video store.
Okay, you're tuned to WBZ. My name is Norm Nathan. You didn't ask, but I thought, hey, it's only fair that I tell you. A couple of messages, this message, then we'll take some more phone calls. It's fun, it's affordable, and it's just 2 hours from downtown Boston. It's the overnight sensation of the summer. It's a complete vacation getaway for $99 that includes foreign adventure, meals, private room, live entertainment, casino excitement, and more. It's a 23-hour round-trip cruise aboard the Scotia Prince, New England's overnight cruise ship to Nova Scotia. The Prince sails from Portland, Maine every evening and features dining, great entertainment, and wonderful bargains in its duty-free gift shop. And who knows, you may strike it rich in the casino. So call now for availability, because only a certain number of staterooms can be set aside each day at this special rate, and certain restrictions do apply. Ask the information operator for Prince of Fun Day Cruises in Portland, or call toll-free. Free phone call to 1-800-341-7540. That's 1-800-341-7540. Doesn't that sound like a fun way to spend a night? Ads with details are in the Herald and the Globe every week. The overnight sensation from Prince of Fundy Cruises. Now at a sensational $99.
WBZ AM 1030 and WBZ TV present Dynamation.
Now through July 24th at the World Trade Center, come and see the dinosaurs. These robotic life-size replicas growl, roar, and behave just like the real thing. Enter the world of dinosaurs and learn all about these amazing giants of the past. For more information, call 1-800-DINOSAUR. Call now and ask about special birthday parties.
Come to the World Trade Center and venture into the past with the world of dinosaurs and WBZ AM 1030.
Okay, here's, could this really be Bruce Lee?
That's right.
It is. I thought you died.
I'm coming out of the shadows.
I thought you died a while back.
Oh, no. Me and Elvis have been hiding out.
Oh, I see. You didn't really die. You're just a...
I've been teaching Elvis the finer parts of martial arts.
Oh, I see. Because we hear...
He's been teaching me how to sing. I'm not ready to sing yet, but maybe later on I'll sing for you over the radio.
Okay. So, because we always hear about Elvis Presley sightings, but we never hear about Bruce Lee sightings.
Oh, yeah. Well, I've been hiding out pretty good, you know, and I heard Elvis wanted, he can't perfect the martial arts, even though he was blacked out, but I figured I might as well, find him, and I did.
Yeah, because I never knew Bruce Lee had a New England accent.
Well, we've been hiding out in Boston for the last couple of years or so.
Oh, I see. So you picked up the local accent.
Oh, yeah. Well, I went to UCLA, too, I had that California accent for a while.
Yeah.
Me and Kareem hanging out and shit. But I have a word or two for the Macho Man.
Yeah?
I challenge him to a wrestling match.
Oh, that's good. Going to be...
All she has to do is ask Elizabeth. Because she already knows. She said the reason why they call him Macho Man is because potato chips, he crumbles under pressure.
Oh, I see.
That's where he got the name Macho. He thinks it's something else, but that's what Elizabeth told me in Elvis.
Oh, I see. She uses that in a derogatory way, not a very nice way.
He don't know. That's why he has that big head of his, But anyway, that's why I call it. I'm just a...
We'll I'm sure he's heard the challenge.
Oh, yeah, you have to do me one favor, though. So,
uh-huh.
it would be a good fight, you know, fair fight.
Yeah.
You have to be the referee.
Okay, it's a deal.
All right.
I'll jump up and down and run around just like a real referee. I'll bring my own bell.
All right, thanks, man.
Okay, Bruce Lee. Here's Bobby, who's calling from New Hampshire. Hi, Bobby, on WBZ.
Oh, Norm, who are these ham and eggers that keep calling you?
I don't have any idea. I feel like the entire program has gotten away from me today.
Someone called Bruce Lee?
Yeah.
Well...
Yeah, he's the spirit of the dead Bruce Lee, I guess.
Oh, it's very weird, Norm.
It is a weird night, Bobby, but that's the way it sometimes is on a holiday weekend.
Oh, you're talking to the brain. Announcer extraordinaire.
That's you?
Yes.
The brain, the announcer extraordinaire. Are you in broadcasting?
Bobby the Brain Heenan. Doesn't ring a bell.
Bobby the Brain Heenan. And now, you work at a radio station up there in New Hampshire?
No, I work for the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, I see. You work for... Do you really?
Yes.
I don't know. I've gotten to a point where I'm not quite sure who's telling me what.
Well, that Macho Man call was true. That was the real Macho Man.
Oh, that was the real Macho Man. Oh, that's good. That's good. The young fellow called Eric...
Yes.
...called seemed to believe it also was, too.
Ham and egger.
You think little Eric is a ham and egger?
Yeah.
I see. Okay. He sounds more like maybe a cream of wheat and a pablum or something like that.
What's a little kid like that doing up at 2:50 in the morning?
Well, it's just kind of the appeal I have to so many people of all ages. They just, they figure, let's listen to Norm Nathan. The heck with it. Even if we have to lose sleep, it'll be worthwhile.
Yeah.
I'm saying that because I just made that up.
Well...
Hi, old sport. How you doing?
I'm doing weirdly. Actually, kind of weirdly. Weirdly today.
It's been one of those nights, hasn't it?
It's been bizarre. Yeah, it really has. It's kind of funny because in broadcasting, they talk in terms of the demographics. That is, having a younger audience is looked upon as more favorable than having an older audience. And we've had almost all kids the whole night, which is probably fits in beautifully with the way most executives of broadcasting would like it, except most of them have been weird. So that kind of counter sets it. I've been waiting for some older person with somebody I could talk to, and there you are.
I usually try to call when I can add some sort of semblance of foolishness to the program. But tonight I felt I should order it. The order of the day would be to try to add a semblance of seriousness to the program.
Yeah, some kind of reason, I think, or some kind of reasonableness, I think, would not be out of order at all.
I'm sorry I missed you 2 weeks ago down at Brant Rock.
I didn't get down there.
Well, you didn't.
No, I was on the station, and I feel badly about that. I did it by phone instead of going down, because I had worked the night before, and as always, and some other things had come up, and I just couldn't bring myself to travel that far. It's about... maybe about 100 miles from where I live. Or maybe not. Yeah, close to that, probably 80 miles, something like that. So anyway, I called and we did a thing on the phone, and so it worked out that way.
Yeah, I did exactly the same thing. I worked the same night you do. Well, this night, obviously.
Oh, yeah.
And I usually sleep in 02 or 03, and we had the wife had a couple of things planned, a family thing, and so it just... Oh, I know what it was. My niece got married. That's exactly what I went to. I was in Plymouth that day.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So I didn't make it, and I was sorry because it was my big opportunity
to
get an autographed picture.
I don't know that I would have carried around pictures of me. I probably wouldn't have had them anyway, but it would have been nice to say hello to you. We'll do that again. We'll do that sometime in the future.
That sounds good.
Okay, you're nice to call, Mike, and I appreciate that.
It's my pleasure, sir.
Take care of yourself.
Take care.
Okay, bye-bye. Okay, the WBZ AccuWeather forecast, exclusive official weather station, meteorologist Jay Shulman, who says some rain, drizzle through the night, cloudy, lows about where they are now. 64 degrees outside our WBZ studios at the moment. The outlook for today, Saturday, skies may brighten with high temperatures in the mid-70s. Saturday night, patchy dense fog may be in store again in some areas. Low 64 to 68. Sunday, partly sunny, very warm, highs 86. And the extended forecast from Jay Shulman for Monday and Tuesday, both days should be partly sunny, hot, and humid. And there is a chance of a thunderstorm either Monday or Tuesday, maybe a little, maybe both days. High temperatures 86 to 90 degrees. And again in Boston, 64 degrees in Boston. Right now, I'm Norm Nathan with you through the night till 5 o'clock this morning. And whatever I can do for you, by all means, just give me a call and we'll work it out.
Hello, this is Steve Allen. The folks who make the Resolve Stop Smoking kit receive this letter from a Mr. F.G. of Seward, Alaska. Let me share it with you. Quote, the Resolve system is working for me. I promise my lungs that I can quit even after 35 years. End of quote. He wrote about the stop smoking kit discovered in Switzerland called Resolve. It contains no drugs or nicotine. Instead of cigarettes, inhale on a long-lasting substitute you never light up. Enjoy its taste until you're rid of nicotine addiction. A supply of special filters and an audio cassette of me interviewing Dr. Margaret Seidman, an ex-smoker, helps all the way. Get Resolve and quit smoking or money back.
A Resolve kit plus extra filters is $19.95 plus shipping and handling. Send a $22.95 check to Resolve, P.O. Box 9113, Boston, Mass. 02134. That's $22.95 to Resolve, P.O. Box 9113, Boston, Mass. 02134.
Okay, Desiree's on the line with us. Last time we talked with Desiree, who's down in Kentucky, we're talking about your future mother-in-law being in Yugoslavia and seeing if we could arrange a three-way hookup with you and her, and apparently it doesn't look too promising.
Well, this is what I called her to ask her if it was all right, okay? And she said that privately she would talk to you off the air about her country, but really, she didn't even want to do that because she is scared because of everything that is going on there. See, when she talks to me about the country and everything, it's usually in a letter. We don't talk too much about it over the phone because she fears that they may, there's a lot of listening going on over there.
It's not the freest country in the entire world.
No, and she really fears for that. And she said that, you know, if you wanted to talk about Patrick and me and everything, that'd be fine. But she really does fear that. She doesn't really like to give her opinion right now about that. But she said that, she said if anything's settled down, maybe she'd feel a little bit more comfortable. Because things are as bad as they are right now, she's kind of afraid of that.
I can understand that. I understand that.
But she told me to tell you, how do I put it into words? Thank you nicely for wanting her to be on the air.
Well, that's very, very nice. That's right. You know, you're very nice to have called her, too. Your fiancé there may not be too pleased with another phone call, a toll call. But I appreciate you doing it. No, I understand how she feels. It's tough to be there right now, and I would guess it'd be tough to talk about it because you don't know who's listening. It's not like...
Even when I'm on the phone with her, I noticed some things we're really careful about, and I should have thought to have told you, but I wasn't really thinking. You know, she just really doesn't like to talk too much about what's going on over there. We don't really talk about her country. She's coming over here, as a matter of fact, like within 10 or 12 days.
Oh, okay, as soon as that.
Does
she write you very much about conditions in Yugoslavia? Does she dare write it?
She'll write it and she'll send me stuff, about it. And usually she sends packages and stuff. And, she'll write little letters in there about, how she feels and how she wants to come home. And she called yesterday about trying to get out of there. And on Monday she's supposed to go in. She might leave next Thursday. And if the plane takes her to Chicago, and we'll go pick her up, and she'll stay for a while here. Because she's really scared.
She's a native of Yugoslavia, so is she?
What do you mean, born there?
Yeah.
I mean,
that's her home country. So your fiancé is a Yugoslav also, then? He was born there.
He was born in Paris.
Oh, my goodness, what an international family you're going to be marrying into.
Yeah.
I see. Has his family been in Yugoslavia for, like, several generations?
Yes. His last name is, Serbian. It's carried on. It's a traditional name there. I've learned a lot about their language and everything there. It's really interesting.
Yeah. Is he sympathetic toward Slovenia and Croatia trying to break away? Does he talk about that?
Yes, he does. He says that he just really wants peace. He hates to see all them innocent. It's a lot of children over there that are dying, he says, and that really bothers him. He's really sensitive, and he says it's the children and everything that are getting hurt and killed that he just wishes one way or another would just settle down.
Okay.
He's not really He wants to go back over there, you know, right now because of his mother, but because she said now she'd come over here. His father lives over here. They're still married, but...
Oh, I see. Has his father lived here for a long time? Are they separated? Or?
No, they're married.
I know they're married, but they're not living together, so obviously...
Well, the only reason for that is, I mean, they still love each other and everything. The only reason that they don't live together is because when they got married, his family and some of her family was here, not many. They came over here, and they had better job offers, but her mother's over there, and her mother's not been doing too good.
For
the past 7 years, she's been over there most of, you know...
Oh, I see. Okay.
But they're still married.
Okay. Hey, thank you for trying, Desiree. I appreciate it. Well understand.
Okay. Well, and it was nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you. Good luck to you.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay. I'm sorry we can't talk to the lady from Yugoslavia, but I can understand that. It's a pretty strong dictatorship in Yugoslavia itself. I'm kind of leaning towards Slovenia and Croatia. I hope they do manage to break away, become independent and free and all of that kind of business. It's a tricky situation there. And I can understand how somebody living in Yugoslavia would rather not get on the phone and make a big deal about it. Call me 254-1030 if you want to play the birthday game. We'll do that after the news.
WBZ Boston. When you need up-to-the-minute news, weather, and traffic information, you can depend on Boston's news station. WBZ AM 1030.
From ABC News, I'm Marty McNeely. A spokesman for the government of Slovenia says the Republic is freeing hundreds of captured federal troops and complying with other federal demands to try to avert war. In response to that, the Yugoslavian government says the National Army will halt its attacks on the independent CP Republic.
Meanwhile, Soviet President Mikhail Gorbachev is warning that the bloodshed in Yugoslavia should serve as a warning about what could happen in the Soviet Union. ABC's Mark Bauman says Gorbachev made his remarks Friday following talks with German Chancellor Helmut Kohl in Moscow.
The Kohl-Gorbachev meeting was supposed to have focused on Western aid and Soviet economic reform. But at a news conference in the Ukraine, which followed several hours of talks between the two men, Gorbachev instead turned his attention to Yugoslavia. The Soviet leader said that the slide toward civil war in that country should serve as a warning to all Soviets. "We cannot break apart," he said. "It would pose an enormous risk." Currently, there are six Soviet republics refusing to sign Gorbachev's new union treaty. And this week, the independence-minded government in Lithuania endorsed Yugoslavia's Slovenian separatists. Mark Bauman, ABC News, Moscow.
More news after this.
If you do not have a will, did you know that the laws of the state and not you will determine who receives your property and in what amounts? Who manages the affairs of your estate? Also, your choice as guardian of your minor children may never be known. Now, for only $12.95 plus shipping, you can make your own will quickly, safely, and legally with the American Will Kit. To order, use your credit card and call now, 1-800-348-5500. Money back if not satisfied. See package for details. Call 1-800-348-5500.
I went from house to house, you know, getting any food or clothes they'd give me. Then I handed it all out to any needy people in the neighborhood. That's it.
Jack Powell is one of the little answers to the big problems facing every community in America. And because there are more people than problems, things will get done. All you have to do is something. Call the Points of Light Foundation at 1-800-677-7309. Do something good. Feel something real. A message from the Ad Council.
Saddam Hussein now says UN inspectors are free to check out Iraqi nuclear sites, but the acting U.S. ambassador to the United Nations is taking a wait-and-see attitude. Alexander Watson says what matters is not what Saddam says, but what he does. Two Swedish engineers held hostage by Kashmiri militants since late March have been freed. The Press Trust of India says it's not immediately known what condition the two men are in. Meanwhile, a Dutchman and a Belgian kidnapped by suspected Muslim bandits in the southern Philippines have been freed unharmed. They were seized Thursday and released today without any ransom being paid. Crime rates are rising in some of our national parks like Yellowstone and Yosemite, and they're often overcrowded. Actor Robert Redford, who's an active environmentalist, told ABC's Nightline that we should remember the original mandate of the Park Service.
The idea was to keep these parks as a place to invite the soul and to that are really sacred, that reflect our pride in our country. And the fact is, this is a great country. It has a lot of substance and strength, and it certainly has a lot of beauty. And here is a mandate that sort of puts into law that respect.
Redford recalled his first visit to Yosemite about 20 years ago.
Seeing it really changed my life. It introduced me to a feeling and an attitude that led eventually to my concern and work in the environment.
Baseball owners voted unanimously to grant Denver and Miami, the two National League expansion franchises. The Florida Marlins and the Colorado Rockies will start playing in 1993. We got some reaction from these fans in Denver.
It's great, but I mean, we've known for a couple weeks, but it's nice that it's official. Yeah, I am. In fact, I'm on the list for season tickets, and I can't wait to get them.
I feel great about it. I'm a Dodgers fan myself, but I can't wait until I get to go and see a baseball game live. I've never seen one before.
Delta Airlines is offering to buy a package of Pan Am Airways assets, including the Pan Am shuttles, some transatlantic routes, and some aircraft. This is ABC News.
All over America, there's a movement to do something about our environment, because if we don't protect the Earth from ourselves, we won't have a safe place to live. But did you ever stop to consider what happens to someone when they take drugs? It's not that different from building a toxic waste dump in your brain. Not only does it destroy the environment of your body and your mind, even if you go on living, who could call it a life? If you or someone you know needs help, call 1-800-662-HELP. Brought to you by the Partnership for a Drug-Free America.
For the ABC Information Network, I'm Marty McNeely.
I'm Deborah Daigle, WBZ News. The school committee is not what's wrong with the Boston school system. That's the reaction of committee member John Grady to Governor Weld signing a law abolishing that elected body. Weld has turned the reins over to Mayor Flynn to choose a school board, saying this should improve the school system. But Grady thinks the problems with Boston's school system go much deeper than that. Critics expect a court challenge to emerge to stop the new law from taking effect. The Seabrook nuclear plant's fifth shutdown of the year has been traced to a short circuit in dirty electrical connectors on one of four reactor coolant pumps. A spokesman says that when the pump stopped working, the plant turned off automatically at 8:25 Thursday morning and disconnected itself from the New England power grid. No word yet on a restart time. A Chinese student attending Harvard University conducted a survey that showed overwhelming rejection on the part of Chinese students to their native country's communist ideology. A poll by a political science graduate showed that 54% of Chinese students in the U.S. prefer American democracy versus 0.5% favoring their country's communist system. And now with the exclusive WBZ AccuWeather forecast, here's meteorologist Jay Shulman.
Hi, Deborah. For the overnight period and Saturday morning, it'll be dry and damp with a bit of rain and drizzle. There will also be areas of fog. Low overnight, 60. The sky may brighten Saturday afternoon, high 74. Patchy dense fog may form again on Saturday night, low 64 to 68. On Sunday, partly sunny and very warm, high 86. This is meteorologist Jay Shulman at the weather station WBZ AM 1030.
Temperature is now 64 degrees. It seems to be getting a little bit warmer.
WBZ is committed to bringing you the latest news 24 hours a day. And when we're not reporting the news, we're talking about it. Here's WBZ's Norm Nathan.
Thank you very much. And what we're going to do right first of all is to check a few things. Number one would be traffic. And that's from the WBZ 24-hour traffic network. Jack Hart has the information on that. And, Jack, what in heaven's name is going on? And I hope something.
Lots and lots, Norm. We actually have an accident occurring. Route 3 heading southbound in Hanover by interchange by exit 13. We do have a car involved. Some minor injury in that situation. Some debris will be lingering once that's cleared away. Just clearing away that accident on Route 1A, the Linway in Lynn. That was a hit-and-run situation. Some minor injury there as well. The downtown area doing pretty well. Still a few police chases going on as they chase after the less-than-sober motorists. Do watch out there. And after 6 a.m., expect delays on Route 128 in the Burlington-Waltham stretch while people head over towards Hanscom Air Force Base for festivities there. I'm Jack Hart, WBZ, 24-hour traffic network.
Okay, Jack, you'll stand by because We're going to play the dumb birthday game in just a minute.
Absolutely.
You're a good person.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
It's 8 minutes after 3 o'clock. Let me take care of some other business. First of all, the lottery numbers in Massachusetts, the daily number was 8247. 8247. And the Mass Millions, 8, 18, 22, 27, 28, 29. Bonus number 4. Jackpot, close to $8 million. Nobody won it. The next jackpot then will be worth somewhere in the area of $9 million. Red Sox, we had some great pitching, but Kevin Morton, who pitched his first Major League game, beat the Detroit Tigers at Fenway Park 10-1. It was just lovely. Jack Clark did well. He drove in something like 7 runs. Toronto also won, so the standings remain the same with the Red Sox 4.5 games out. The Detroit Tigers, however, not breathing quite as heavily on the heels of the Red Sox since they lost a little bit of ground. They're now 6 games out, and that's the way it shapes up as I see it right now. We'll check the birthday game, too. We'll explain that in just a minute here on WBZ. But first, watch this.
Did you know that every day in this country, a car is stolen every 20 seconds? That's why police need your help. Because car theft is a major problem, the 220,000 members of the National Fraternal Order of Police have initiated Operation Lockup and recommend using the club, the anti-theft device that is highly visible and renders your car undrivable. It's the only vehicle anti-theft device recommended by police. The time-tested club is tough to defeat. It's made of tempered steel, yet easy for anyone to use. By simply locking it across your steering wheel, it makes your car impossible to steer. Once in place, the bright red club is so visible that would-be thieves move on to easier targets. Remember, too, that compared to the expensive electronics devices that tend to give off false alarms, the club, priced at under $60, is affordable and it's guaranteed. But don't be fooled by imitators. The one police recommend has the name The Club on the handle. The Club, available at ADAP, Caldor, Ace Hardware, Ames, Spags, Kmart, and Truck Stops of America.
Again, of course, it's time to play the exciting dumb birthday game in which I tell you the names of people who were born on this very date, today's date being July 6th, and all you have to do is tell me how old you think they are on this date, which is, again, a really stupid premise, but I don't know, it just seems like a fun thing to do. Thank you. Okay, let's talk with the members of the panel and see. We have Kristen, our friend Kristen, who's in Dorchester with us.
Good morning, Noel.
Good morning, Kristen. How you doing?
Okay, how are you?
Fine. Has the weekend been really wonderful for you?
Oh, very wonderful, especially the call from Randy Macho Man Savage.
Oh, are you aware of him?
Yes, I know everything about him. Well, almost.
Oh, tell us some little thing that he would not want you to tell us.
I think he's already married to Elizabeth.
Oh, you think he's already married?
Yes, because I've read many a magazines and heard it many a times that they were always married to begin with.
Oh.
So maybe they want it just to be known now by the public.
Oh, a little bit of showbiz here, maybe, or something.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. We'll have to hit him with that next if he calls again.
Who knows?
Who knows? Here's Sam in Newton. Hi, Sam.
Buongiorno, old sport.
Hey, buongiorno a voi. Come sta quest'oggi, eh?
Muy bien.
Molto bene. I'm trying to learn how to speak better than this. It takes time because Roma non fu fatta in un giorno, eh?
Eat a lot of spaghetti.
That's what it means. Okay. Nice. Is this the first crack at this you've had?
No, I was disgraced a couple months ago, but I'm trying to call back and redeem myself.
Okay, good enough. Now, this is PN in Medford. How you doing, PN?
Good. Yo, what's up?
Okay, we talked with you a little. What's that?
Yep.
Oh, that's right. You did the rap song. I forgot. Anyway, this is your first crack at playing the dumb birthday game, is it?
Yeah, boy. Yep.
Well, I imagine this must be an exciting moment, and welcome. And also Jack, who's been with us before.
How you doing, Norm?
Yesterday to pick a date at random. I'm doing fine, Jack. How about you?
Not too bad.
Okay, here's Tony, of course, who's with us a lot. Tony is calling from the control room, which is about
6-7 miles?
It's about 15 feet from where I am at this moment. How you doing, Tony?
I'm doing all right.
Tony's been
park.
Okay, now how can I bring in Jack Hunt?
Oh, hold on. Now, wait a minute.
Okay,
we really don't want him to play tonight.
No, because Jack is at Traffic Central, and yeah, here's Jack.
Hello.
Hello, Jack.
Hello.
Got some great birthdays. What I'd like to do is start out with one that maybe everybody knows, or a lot of people know, because it would have been publicized along with her age. She's the former First Lady, and it gives me great pleasure to mention the fact that she is the former First Lady. Anyway, Nancy Reagan. Nancy Reagan's birthday today. How old do you think she is, Kristen?
I'll say 69.
Okay, what do you think, Sam? How old is Nancy Reagan?
71.
And PN, what do you think?
Yo, she's a big
7-0. We've got to wrap all the ages. Okay. Okay, what do you think, Jack?
I know she's quite a few years younger than Ron, so I would say 65.
Okay, even the Earth is a few years younger than Ron. What do you think, Tony? How old is Nancy Reagan today?
I'll say 68.
Okay. And Jack Hart and his orchestra, what do you think?
Oh, I'll go along with 68 as well.
68, okay. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we check the files here, all the birth records, and see how old she is. She's probably the age we've got is probably a year or 2 years. She's probably a year or two younger than what she really is anyway, but she's listed as 70 years old, which is exactly what the rapper P.N. said. Yeah, man, you said it. You said it day and night. When you said 70, you said it right. Oh, yeah. God, I'm awful at that. That's really pitiful. Okay, so that's one for you, PN. Let's go to Sylvester Stallone, Sly Stallone. Rocky, his birthdays. He was born on July 6th. Also, we'll start with Jack Hart on this one. And how old is Sylvester Stallone?
Let's see. The first Rocky movie came out in, I think, 77 or 78. So that's 13 years. The guy's got to be 44.
44. I like the way you reason things out.
Yes, indeed.
It's just so darn nice.
Mathematical configurations.
Tony, what do you say?
I'm going to say 44.
Ooh. You just because you have a lot of respect for Jack.
Well, I'm, trading. Jack agreed with me the last one and lost.
Well, that's right.
And hope for the best.
On this one.
That's right. You both said the same age last time, too.
That's right.
Jack and Malden, what do you say?
42.
Okay. And PN? PN, I'm trying to do a rhyme for you.
44.
44?
Yeah.
40. So you're saying the same as Tony and Jack says, eh?
Oh, yeah. Yep.
And that's a fact. He picked the same age as Tony and Jack. Oh, yeah. What do you say, Sam?
43.
What's that?
43.
43, okay, because it's hard to hear you. PN seems to do the rap stuff, even when he's not being talked to, which is okay. Kristen, what do you say?
Mom, I think you're wonderful at rapping.
Christmas time, they all come flocking to him.
I don't think there's anybody better than you.
Yeah, through pain and holocausts and natural strife, I do my rapping because that's my life. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
MC Norm.
How old do you think Sly Stallone is, Kristen?
I'll say 45.
You'll say 45. Okay, let's go to the birthday files again. We'll check the birth records. What was that?
That was the Current Affair Ka-Chung. You want to hear it again?
Oh, yeah, let me hear that again.
Wasn't she a newscaster, Connie Ka-Chung?
Yeah.
Sorry.
That's
okay. Oh, forgive me.
Anyway, Sylvester Stallone is 45 years old, exactly as Kristen said.
Thank you.
Oh, my.
Sorry, Tony.
Okay, here's one. Bert Ward. That is so pretty. I know a lot of you wanted
Robin.
To hear the whole thing and dance.
That Robin?
Right. That's Robin. That's right. From Batman and Robin. That young, short little guy was born also on July 6th.
You got to wonder.
Okay, let me ask all you ladies and men, but first I'm going to ask PN.
Stop it. Oh, yeah. Word to Norm.
Yeah, you, here it comes. A word to Norm. Just a mention of his name makes me feel so warm. And anyway, how old is
52.
52, you say?
The
little guy, Burt Ward Robin, is 52. Okay. And fresh from his triumph yesterday, he's back, so let's ask the guy from Malden. His name is Jack. Oh, yeah.
Well, I was going to say 53.
I think I'm making myself.
I'll change my mind to 53.
Yep. Okay. Sam, what is, Sam, what do you think?
50.
50?
Just 50.
Okay. And Kristen?
No, can I hire you for my next party?
Yes, yes. Just so long as I can gorge on cake and come even fatter and have more pimples.
How much do you think you'd charge?
Yep, yep.
we'll work out some kind of arrangement.
Okay, I'll say...
Oh, Pian, hold it. Hold. Yeah, no. Just hold it till we call on you, Pian, okay? Because it's very distracting. I'm sorry, Kristen, what is this?
I'll say 56.
56. Okay. Tony, what do you say?
55.
And Jack?
Let's see, 49.
49, okay.
What? That's a long song.
No, that's the chairman of the Nathan Family Cousins Club opening one of our meetings.
Boy.
The Burt Ward actually is 45 years old today. You all guessed well above his age. Hmm. And the man who came the closest was Jack, who said, Jack Hart, who said 49.
Totally correct answers, Norm.
Isn't it incredible the vast repertoire we have here at WBZ that is at Tony's fingertips? Okay, Burt Ward, anyways, 45. Jack wins the second round, so we have PN, Kristen, and Jack all have won a round. Della Reese, I hope you know Della Reese. She's quite a good vocalist, more on a jazz-oriented side. And let me ask Jack of Malden first. How old is Della Reese?
54.
Okay, and Jack Hart, what do you think?
Oh, 57.
Ooh, 57. Okay. And Sam?
58.
Kristen?
60.
And Tony?
58.
And PN?
Oh, yeah. Della Reese gotta be 60, my home.